And welcome to a new video. In this video, we are going to talk about a specific solution and services in the B2B environment. It has led to many different and creative solutions due to increasing needs for logistic transportation, warehousing, and distribution are offered, sometimes by organizations which originally were not logistic experts, for example, Procter & Gamble, and the application service provider offer the deployment, hosting and management of packaged software from a central facility, for example, Oracle and Linkshare, or the outsourcing or function in the process of e-commerce, such as web hosting, security, and customer care solution are offered by outsourcing provider, such as eShare, NetSales, and Universal Access. Auction solution software for the operation and maintenance of real-time auctions in the internet are provided by, for example, companies like Moai Technologies and OpenSite Technologies. Content management software for the facilitation of website content and delivery is delivered by another ones like Interwoven on ProcureNet. This web-based e-commerce enables like Commerce One offer a browser-based XML enabled purchasing automation software. So what does it involves? So the impact it have in the e-commerce is very, very high. Why? Firstly, about the ethics way, sometimes known as moral philosophy, is a branch of philosophy that involves systematizing, defending, and recommending concept of right and wrong conduct, often addressing disputes of moral diversity. Philosophical ethics investigate what is the best way for human to live and what kind of actions are right or wrong in particular circumstances. So the morality is a differentiation of intention, decision, and actions between those that are good or right and those that are bad or wrong. So morality can be a body of standards or principles derived from a code of conduct from a particular philosophy, religion, or culture. Or also it can be derived from a standard that a person believes should be universal. The development of the information and communication technology is breathtaking. We see a double of computer power every 18 months. Business processes and business activities are increasingly based on ITC system or even completely take over by ICT systems. The firms without any employee seems to be a realizable vision. What does this mean for employment then? Calls for data storage are still decreasing. So databases with detailing profiles or human beings are built and are used at acceptable cost. How much can the customer be manipulated? We see an ongoing progress in the area of data analysis. So human beings can be considered from different perspective and they also will be assessed and valued, but only economically. And the behavior of human beings can be forecasted. What about the free will of customers? Significant programs is also made in the area of networks and data communication. Data can be transferred and analyzed all over the world. Do we see the end of privacy on this? So we have to ask ourselves several questions like, are we allowed to do everything we are able to do in the actual law preferences? Which is thought will be done sooner or later? How can we protect ourselves or our privacy? And in which society do we want to live? Like this world of economics, technology is driving us through. What is the right balance between ethics, technology, and economics? So let's discuss about the ethical aspects of ICT. The information rights and information studies. Stakeholders of information management are single person as well as organizations. So the privacy protection must have a high priority in e-commerce. The basis are the human rights and constitution of a state. For example, we'll find the Article 10, Clause 1 in the German Constitution. It says that privacy of correspondence, post and telecommunication is unviolable. However, the Clause 2 of the same Constitution says that restrictions are only allowed on the basis of a law. Further, the German Constitution says in the Article 13, Clause 1, the sanctity of a home is unviolable. So there are a lot of privacy concerns around in marketing because technology has become so powerful in these last times. So for example, data mining or data usage, platforms like Facebook or the advantages in this area of biometrics. So several questions have to be asked as well, like under which circumstances may it be allowed to invade someone's private sphere? How is the private sphere defined? Where are the boundaries due to content in time? How can one protect his private sphere? Must we force to better protect the our private sphere? We find some interesting approaches to the differentiation and protection of the private sphere and the exposure to information. So we can define six basic rules. The first one is that the access to computer and all system which can help you to learn more about this world should be unlimited and complete. The practical experience should always be preferred. The second one is that the all information should be free, as well the ministry authority and the simulated decentralization take places. And hackers should be judged according to their hacking activities only and not according to apparent criteria like certificates, age, race, or social position. So with computers you can make art and create beauty as well, of course, and the computers can turn your life for the better. Mr. Wu Hulan, the co-founder of the German Chaos Computer Club, has added two rules to this. Do not trust the data of other people and use the public data to protect the private data. In the USA, the Electronic Frontier Foundation was founded in 1919, and their main slogan is defending your rights in the digital world. That fights for freedom primarily in the courts, bringing and defining lawsuits even when that means taking on the US government or Laird's corporation. What about the property rights and duties? The German Constitution says in the Article 14, Clause 2, ownership obligates. Its application has to serve the public welfare. What does this mean for the intellectual properties? Which obligation does the owner have? And how can he protect his information assets? This is a very important issue for everybody of us because the major security concerns in the internet are global bank theft, data theft, and social network data breaches. So the question we have to ask ourselves as well are, how can we ensure that the salesman sells only that which he owns or which he is authorized to sell? Where are the boundaries between theft and copy? How can we distinguish between legal and illegal trade? When is a transaction deal and where is not? So then we have to think about the accountability and check. About this area, there should at least be a responsibility of a liability for damages. And the question could be, who is responsible for damage caused by a machine, which is controlled by a software? Who is liable if data of human beings are stolen? How can you guard your organization against damage caused by breakdowns of ITC systems? Also, who is responsible if wrong or reputation damaging information is distributed via internet? And how can you make a person responsible if he or she does not live in your country? So then, for all of us, the objective in this area has to be protect our data and system, protect the rights of individuals, guarantee the security of the society, the whole society of course, protect the institution we are very, very on this, and protect, of course, the values for everybody of us. So in our next video, we are going to talk the overall impact of e-commerce. So now it's everything for today. Hope you have enjoyed this content, and see you in the next one.